So here we are at Maker Faire, and as our old world continues to deteriorate and a lot of our animals become endangered, we have found an innovator that's replacing the animal technology, and he's built an amazing giraffe. Lindsay, tell me about this.
What we have here, this is the Electric Giraffe Project, and what we have done is, have you another model? Do you have a model? We've taken this toy from Japan, and it's kind of like the V'ger thing in Star Trek 1, you know, where, you know, they took the machine planet, you know, gave the little tiny robot, you know, a chance to live and become some gigantic huge machine. Same thing with this. What we've done is we've taken this little toy and we drove it up to 24 times as large, and that's exactly what the big machine does.
So talk about science imitating art, life imitating art. This is it.
Yeah, this is what we're done. What we're attempting to do is take a ton of iron and put as much life into it as possible. In the end, the giraffe's head is going to be looking around, chewing, looking at things, looking at you. We'll be wearing little talismans. It will know where we are. As we walk around, it might attempt to follow us. The idea is to make this thing as alive as possible. And with the children and everything else like that already, they're just completely wild about it. They get up to it and it's already alive for them. You know, they pet it, it laughs, it talks to you, it wiggles its ears, it knows when you're touching it. We have little piezoelectric touch sensors all over the head. So this is a piece of artwork that, just like an animal that you would want to pet and want to interact with, that's what this one is too. When all the classes were coming through here with all the kids and stuff, the kids wouldn't touch it at first because they were told, don't touch anything. And I break those rules. And I say, hey, come on in, touch it, pet it, you have to pet it. And the kids just go completely nuts. And that's part of the huge reward of this.
The adults go, I'm 50 years old, I'm going nuts.
That's true. That's another thing. Of all ages, everybody wants to ride and play and touch and contribute. I get no shortage of help, you know, from people who want to participate.
Oh, I bet. But, the technology behind this and what you're able to do and what you've been able to create with this, I mean, this is the essence of what Maker's Faire is. But more importantly, this is the essence of what everyone needs to participate in to be able to sustain our planet and to be able to mold and grow into this new era.
That is true. I think the most disturbing thing about the new era is everything that we're buying is this pre-built little tiny, you know, little object of something, you know, iPhones and all those fun things, and nobody knows how any of it works.
Right.
That is, you know, we can't become just a nation of consumers.
Right.
We'll be in trouble.
Right.
You know, we need to know how to build things and how to make things. And I'm hoping that, you know, kids and their parents are going to be, you know, galvanized by this thing and buy some models, buy some toys, sit down with the kids, show them screwdrivers, show them tools, and say, hey, you know, here is how things are put together, because you don't want to be helpless when something breaks down.
Right. And, you know, you and I grew up in the age where we would, at, you know, 15, 16 years old, if we had a motorcycle or a mini bike or something, we would take it apart, put it back together again, experiment with it, expand it. And, you know, the recent generations have become programmed to have everything automated, and we need to get back to that creativity, the ability to touch and feel and to take a couple of parts and put them together, rip an old washing machine apart and build something out of it.
Yeah, and you know, looking at a machine like this, or even highly technological machines, people might think, oh, well, tinkering around with stuff isn't going to teach you how that works. Well, let me break that rule for you right here.
Yeah.
Look at this giraffe. See this structure right here? See this leg and how all this is put together? I didn't know how to do anything like this. Even up until recently, I didn't know. But there was one thing I did as a kid. I built wooden model airplanes. And what I did was I went, wait a minute, if I'm going to build something this big out of steel, all I need is a plan. So I drew it on paper. I took it to a CAD operator. I said, can you look at the dimensions and render this life size? He said, yeah. We rendered it life size out of the printer, this huge, gigantic plan. We labeled all the pieces A, B, C, D, F, G, cut them out with scissors, laid it on the steel, marked the steel, chopped it with the chop saw, put it on a flat table, and just like a little model airplane where you cut the little pieces of balsa wood together to match the plans, I cut large pieces of steel together to match the plan. It's no different.
Right.
It's not that different. So there it is. I didn't have to go to engineering school. I have no degree. I have not graduated from anything except high school. And everybody was asking me, how did you build this thing? I said, well, I used the manual. And they said, where'd you get a manual for this? I said, I wrote the manual, and then I built the machine.
There you go.
And that's it. So it's not it's not as hard as a lot of people are making it out.
Well, you know, the Wright brothers didn't order a catalog and flip through it and buy plans to build the first airplane.
They built bicycles.
Right.
And they went, wait a minute, hey, the parts of this bicycle can possibly be used to drive the chains that would drive propellers, and the cables that we're using to operate the brakes, maybe we can operate flaps. And they watched birds fly, and they played around, and next thing you know, they're flying an airplane.
Right.
And there you go. So, you know, the make fair here is, I'm hoping, and I know the people who put the fair on as well, they're hoping to reawaken the spirit of inventiveness in the United States. And that's what we're all here to do.
Well, and, you know, as our world changes and evolves, and certainly this past year has been a perfect example, that we need as much innovation as we can by as many different people as we can. And the innovation is born out of creativity and the ability to grab a piece of metal and weld something to it and make something of it. And that's the great thing about the Maker Faire is, regardless of your talent, regardless of your capacity, you can always build something.
Right. And like I said, it starts small. You know, you look at a jet airplane or something like that, and you're like, well, you know, that, you know, letting my kid play around with little plastic toys isn't going to, you know, get him working on jet airplanes someday. Yes, it will.
Yes.
It
absolutely.
Will. It will.
Well, this is awesome. I can't wait to see more of this, and I really can't wait to see the kids when their eyes light up on this tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. Many of the classrooms came through today, and the kids were just absolutely delighted. They were all over this thing.
I'm all over it.
Yeah, the kids love it.
Lindsay,
thank
you.
And I'm glad you love it. All right. Have a good day.
You too.